So the other day I was complaining to my nigga about how I always lose the sunlight and I can't film anymore and I have to keep waiting and pushing it back and pause. And he gave me this little ring light. I feel like a little Vine star. Now the only catch to this little Timu looking ring light is that I split the profit of this video. And I need a little mathematician nigga in the comments below to tell me what is 35 cents divided by 2, nigga. What is going on, my dear? Lovely, sexy, audacious, fabulous, endearing, thick, voluptuous niggas. Now today on this wonderful, beautiful video, I have a theory. Now as you guys can see for the topic of this video, a nigga is wearing Vetmont. As you guys can see, drip or drown, nigga. Opium gang, stand tall with me. All jokes aside, nigga. Today on this video, we are talking about the fucking homeless Y2K Now to start this video, let me give you a little backstory of how this came about for me. This is why this video hits hard for me. I used to always talk to these girls, these hot babes, and you know, after a while, they're just like, yo, Josan, I'd always thought about these two things about you. I was like, oh, shoot, go ahead. I'm like, kind of enjoyed myself. She's kind of enjoyed it. One, nigga, you always dress and look very homeless. I'm like, oh, wow, Amanda, that is very sweet. That is very sweet. And two, Josan, I always thought you were gay, nigga. Huh? Damn you. Ah, and you know, I am low-key tired of being called the homeless nigga thing. And you know what? I do it to myself because I drink the Natty Daddy. My hair is never retwisted properly. I always have ashy legs, so I kind of do it to myself. But I'd rather say that I am a disheveled nigga. I have the aesthetic of a nigga who's very disheveled, like a nigga who is going to the AA meetings, all the Alcohol Anonymous meetings with a downed hair, but we're a construction worker who lost his job and now he's drinking, nigga, going crazy. And you know, the Vetmont doesn't even help. The Vetmont is just like, it's there, it's just like words to them. They don't give a fuck. And you know what? No one gives a fuck about clothes, because every single time you see on those Instagram comments when all those little dudes are like, Chrome Hearts, Balenciaga Bomber, 6,000, shut up, nigga, first of all, the fits ass. And then you see, of course, my statement just now was validated by all the niggas in the comment section going crazy. They're like, nigga, paid all this bread, dumb nigga by the way, paid all this bread just to look homeless, and some of it for the most part is rep. So not only are you buying fake shit and flexing fake shit, but you're also flexing fake shit just for these little niggas that don't care about fashion, just saw the reel, just like, you know what, let me hate on this nigga just to say that this nigga dresses like ass and you dress like you're homeless. You can thank these three things that got this whole entire homeless nigga epidemic going. So the first one is this Russian nigga. It's this Russian nigga that's been posted on all the Hidden NY type of videos and all this type of shit that's going on, like the little Jupiter pages. And they give a little paragraph and they're like, this nigga, first name, last name. And you're like, this nigga is, he's an iconic Russian nigga who is famous for his multiple styles and different takes on fashion. And you know, at first glance, it's like, damn, you know, for a homeless nigga, He has a lot of versatility. How do you say that word? Fertility? You know what word I'm talking about. He has a lot of that. And second, you just got to think about it. Well, first of all, the nigga is like, they're photographing the nigga. And it's like, are they giving the nigga bread? Where's the GoFundMe for that nigga? The nigga's probably strung out on meth. His balls probably smell like broccoli, boiled broccoli at that. And niggas are just like taking 10 photos of him in different types of the place. Like, yo, can you stand up straight a little? Nigga's kind of strung over. He's kind of hung over on the fucking whatever you call heroin, nigga. And then all of a sudden they're like, can you like stand straight, nigga? Let me take this photo and send it to Hidden NY so he can make a little Instagram article about you. Where's the GoFundMe, nigga? Is he okay? Is he still alive? I don't know. I keep seeing him. And that, like, forever supplemented in my head. What is going on with that nigga? You can thank Kanye for that as well, because his aesthetic is, like, I guess it's, like, very thrashed, like, kind of, like, old and like it looks like it's been through a lot type of outfits and shit like that. And speaking of been through a lot, it looks like it's pre-distressed, it looks crazy, it looks very vintage, is the new Balenciaga. Balenciaga, you are one of the main niggas, because not only do you have a bunch of niggas dressing like this, wearing like $3,000 jeans and all this bullshit and stacking and looking stupid as hell, you have invited a bunch of other niggas, a plethora of Instagram niggas who make these shitty Instagram brands. First they were copying Rick Owens, now they just jumped on the wave of making like super distressed, super pre-pissed on, pre-shitted on jeans. And it's just a whole thing that's just like, we don't really need that. I don't know why this is happening. It's like, you got everyone in the comments, every nigga's just dressing like complete ass, and they're like, but it's Balenci though, and they're like, oh, but like, haha, I've been dressing like a kid from 2005. No, nigga, you're just wearing Louis V and Balenciaga, and you look stupid just because you're layering all these fucking designer things. Does it matter? I'll tell you right now, I can wear this in some booty shorts and some slides and go to the corner store. I tell you that. That outfit alone would fucking wipe out the whole entire thing. My niggas don't understand that because they think that the brands is what make the outfits. And you know, I've been saying this actually recently. FHTV, I think, yeah, FHTV said this recently when he started dropping again. He said the same exact shit. And you know, this epidemic, I wanted to stop because recently I've noticed that it's been going on. It's literally on a whole bunch of comment sections on those like outfit videos or you pay all that. And it's just like, damn. Now I look back at my page, my Instagram. And by the way, you guys can drop the follow too and see if I really was homeless or is it homeless or is it just very disheveled? And you let me know. But yeah, you see it a lot in the comment section. It's just like, fuck, man. Now I look like I'm one of them. And you know, if you scroll down farther enough, that's why I have all the captions on my Instagram, just to let niggas know I've been doing this this disheveled look before this little cringe Y2K aesthetic came on. Yes, it is cringe. It's making me stressed out. Can someone open a GoFundMe for that Russian nigga? No bullshit. Cause I'd honestly be tight if my balls were stinking. I was wearing multiple pants just to stay warm. And the nigga's like, who influenced your style? And I was like, nigga, I am trying to stay warm. I am fighting for dear life, nigga. On that note. I realized I was wearing my hoodie the whole entire video. So it's not as cool when I do the walk off. But anyways, niggas, I digress. Comment, rate, subscribe, guys, for more content, of course. Badass music. Look how ominous and cool I look. I'm gonna put the
game over.